Welcome to part 15 of the Builder Series. This video demonstrates how to create and deploy a customer satisfaction survey using Survey Designer and review survey results. It builds on the use case from previous videos in this series and references the safety application built earlier. Surveys are built into the ServiceNow platform and are available on any instance. They are a great way to get general customer satisfaction data or feedback on a task activity, such as when a request is closed. You can even create public surveys for non-ServiceNow users. Let's take a moment to review the design, assign, and view process for surveys. In the design phase, we identify what data we want to gather with the survey. Next, we identify who will receive the survey and when. Finally, we'll view the survey to ensure that it looks as we expect it to. Luke is the safety manager, and he knows the process and outcomes better than anyone, so we granted him the survey admin role. He's going to design our safety survey and evaluate survey results to ensure that his department is doing a good job. In the Survey Designer, Luke begins by dragging a data type control onto the canvas. He then modifies the question using the gear icon. In this case, he wants to know the overall satisfaction with the service. He can change the question, make it mandatory, or modify other settings. He then adds another question to ask the responder to rate the technician. And another to find out if the issue was resolved to the responder's satisfaction. And finally, a place to gather any additional comments. After the layout is complete, Luke clicks Configuration at the top to provide introduction and closing messages. And under Availability, he could restrict this to a specific set of users or groups, but he leaves it available to anyone and then clicks Save and Publish. Luke has finished the design phase. Now let's take a look at assigning a survey. There are three ways to assign a survey. Assign it manually to each user, schedule it on a particular calendar date or interval, for example, monthly or quarterly to get a net promoter score, or associate it with a trigger condition, such as a safety issue being closed, and have the system send it to get feedback on the experience. Here are all the surveys in our system. Let's open our safety survey record and take a look. Luke doesn't want to have to send out surveys manually, so he's going to use the trigger conditions related list to define a new condition, which will watch for records on the safety issue table and send a survey to the person who opened the issue. The repeat interval indicates the length of time between surveys for a given user. Luke thinks once every 30 days is fine for now. Finally, the condition when he wants to trigger the survey is when the state is complete. He submits it, and then to test how the survey looks, Luke can use this link to view the survey URL and copy it to another browser tab. Things look great. Sometime later, Luke can come back and view the results of his surveys. By going back to View Surveys and opening the record, he can see live data about the response trends and survey summary and know how many are complete or active. Users with the admin, survey admin, or survey reader role can view surveys and related information. And further down on the form, Luke can view the scorecard to get results at the question level. This gives him a good idea of how his department is performing. Now he can set measurable goals for his department and monitor progress. Luke sees the value of surveys for gaining insight, and he's ready to design, assign, and view additional surveys as the need arises. For more information, see our product documentation, knowledge base, or podcast, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.